a mean sticker collection back in the day. I mean, I had scratch and sniff stickers, I had huge stickers, fuzzy stickers, hologram stickers. I'm sure those of you that are around my age, you had a sticker collection as well. I mean, it was a thing to do. Paper Mario Sticker Star for the Nintendo 3DS totally gave me that nostalgic feeling for stickers. And even though it's decades later, it's cool to see that Mario has the same love for stickers as I did. Sticker Star takes place after the Sticker Festival in DeKalb. Bowser crashes the party, he steals the big old comet piece, and he also kidnaps Princess Peach. Surprise! As usual, it's up to Mario to rescue the helpless Princess Peach, and along the way, you have to collect 6 royal stickers to get everything back to normal. If you're looking for an awesome story, you're definitely not going to find it in Paper Mario Sticker Star, but then again, the stories in the Paper Mario games aren't that great to begin with, and at least those games had some type of fleshed out story. There's basically none of that in Sticker Star. Paper Mario games are usually RPGs. Sticker Star, however, is less of an RPG and more of a platforming, puzzle, slash adventure game. There are still turn-based battles, but there isn't any leveling up. All of that's been stripped away, and you can't equip Mario with any items. Now, I missed that aspect of the previous games, but the new sticker mechanic kind of made up for that. You'll find stickers scattered around the world. You can peel them off of walls, and you can peel them off of the ground. Now, the whole battle system is based off of these stickers. So if you want to throw a fireball while you're in a battle, you need to have a fireball sticker. The same can be said for like jumping on your enemies or using your hammer. You have to have those stickers in order to use that move. There are different levels of stickers. You have flashy stickers, which do a little bit more damage than regular stickers. You have big stickers, which do a lot of damage. There's worn out stickers. They don't do as much damage. Now, all of these stickers are really indisposable. They're so easy to come by. They're scattered all throughout these levels. And that shouldn't be a problem, because throughout this entire game, I never had a problem with not having stickers when I was in battle. The stickers are just so easy to find. And if you get close to running out of stickers, you can always go to the shop and buy new ones. I really enjoyed the sticker mechanic. I thought it was a lot of fun and definitely something different. It also required me to use a little bit more strategy when I was in these battles, because you know, you have to use the right sticker for different enemies. Some enemies will be immune to certain effects that these stickers will give off. So you really have to think about which sticker you're going to use at the right time. There's the puzzle solving aspect. Now, this game is set up like an old school Mario game. So you go to different levels and you collect the comet pieces at the end of the level instead of jumping on the flagpole. Exploration plays a really big part in Sticker Star. Throughout the levels, you'll find thing stickers that are effective for boss battles. If you don't find these special stickers, then finishing off the bosses will be rough, since the bosses are really overpowered and it's a little frustrating at times. At times, the puzzles were a little challenging, but they were also clever, and it's definitely something new to the series. There's also this paperization feature, which lets you peel off certain parts of the environment in order for you to solve different puzzles, and that's used a lot later on in the game, and it's a really cool, neat little feature. I really enjoyed that. And you can also use the paperization feature to go into your sticker album, and you can take a sticker from your collection and put in the right spot, and a question mark block will pop up, so that will let you access different parts of the world. I mean, you really just have to pay attention to what's going on around you. This is a beautiful looking 3DS game. Being able to see Mario and all the other characters and even the levels in this game just in paper form, they look spectacular. The 3D is also great. It is very subtle, but it totally enhances the depth in the environment. It took me a little over 20 hours to complete Paper Mario Sticker Star. There's a handful of side missions that you can do, and there's secret doors that you can access in every single level if you have the right sticker. But once you're done with the story mode, there really is no need to go back and replay the game. So Paper Mario Sticker Star isn't your traditional Paper Mario game. The RPG elements have been stripped away, and there isn't really much of a story. But overall, I really did enjoy this game. The presentation blew me away. I liked the puzzles. They were challenging and clever, and I also loved exploring some of these levels. So this is definitely a title you might want to consider if you're looking for a portable adventure game with minimal RPG elements. I want to thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll check you next time.